Hey guys, welcome back. So if you have one of these Peltier wood stove fans and yours has stopped working, maybe you can follow this video and fix yours. Tools you'll need are an assortment of screwdrivers, some heat shrink, a heat gun to go with it, some thermal paste, the Peltier itself, solder, soldering iron, and a snips. So these little fans, they work on pure magic that there is no battery, but somehow they're able to work. So the first little job I did was there's a screw at the back just here and a screw at the front here. So how does it work? Well, I'm going to lift the lid and we're going to see behind the curtain. So this is the Peltier motor or the Peltier battery basically. And what it does is it takes the heat from this side and this the top half is colder. So one side is hot, one side is cold, and that difference creates a voltage and a current. That current is a very small little current and a small voltage. And that's actually enough just to turn the fan. That's how it works. So unfortunately, the little Peltier has actually burnt out of mine. So I bought a new one and we're going to change it. Okay, that's now the bottom half of it separated and we just come in here with the screwdriver, pop it off. Okay, that's now the other half of it separated. So when we pull it apart, one side will have writing on it, the other side won't. I'm not really sure which one is up and down at the moment, but when you reassemble it, you just put the heat gun on the bottom. If it turns, if this spins backwards, you know that you've just mixed it up, so you can swap this upside down then. So with a very small little wiggle, we can pull it off. Okay, and we can set all of this now to one side. So here's our Peltier. We have a second one here. Okay, here we go. That's the code on my one. These two are the exact same. And all we have to do is desolder and cut this little wire here off, resolder it onto this one, and then get ready to reinstall it, and we have the thermal paste, which is the most important thing to have. But okay, let's get down to business and get this done. Okay, with our snips, probably rough bit there, give it a cut. Now with the end soldered, we're going to wrap the heat shrink onto it and then shrink it down. Okay, so next we're going to get the thermal paste, put a nice blob right in the middle. Now we take our Peltier sensor, our new one, and we're going to put it with the wires pointing towards the back, writing on top, and just put it straight down. So we can move it around a little bit. Make sure not to put loads of little tiny ones all over the place, just one in the middle. So when you push it down, the only place it has to go is out. You don't need a huge amount, but we just need it to be pressed down a bit. Okay, now you get some thermal paste on top, and then get ready to put the lid on. Okay, we've just put a blob of thermal paste onto the second end. Now we're going to just drop it straight down. Now that it's sitting on top of it, all we have to do is just give it a little wiggle. Like that, and that'll just settle it down a bit better. And then just get our screws and drop one in there and one in the front. Okay, now it's all connected back in. We just have to tuck away the wires, but that'll be done afterwards. I just want to test it to make sure that it's actually rotating the correct way. The way to do that is to get our heat gun and just leave it. And just leave it here, pointing at the base. Whoo, and it's off. Spinning. Oh, brilliant. Okay, so I can feel the breeze going this way. Brilliant. It is absolutely silent. That's pretty cool. Okay. So now it's just a matter of just tucking away the wires, keeping everything nice and tidy, and then put it on top of the stove.
If you like this video, why not give it a thumbs up, hit subscribe, and I'll see you next time.